Hang on a second, what are you doing with all of those g-? What's going on here?
So I can catch a redback spider.
I'm not sure whether that's going to be any sort of help.
Warning, this video contains graphic images of very deadly spiders that are black and have a red back. If you suffer arachnophobia, this video is not for you.
Well, I'm down in Mummy's garden. I've got my son here and he's watching what I'm doing.
Hi.
Yeah, he's in the background saying hi. I just split some tubs here. This is like another area of Mummy's garden. The greenhouse used to be at the back there. It's now gone because we're trying to do a big clean up and make the place spider free. And as I just split these tubs here, guess who I found? Right in the middle of frame there, one great big giant female redback spider. Isn't she a beauty? Apart from the beautiful redback spider there, just notice on the ground here, as I pull the tub aside, I think this is where lizards and things live, I think. And maybe, that could be eggs. I'm not quite sure. Got my son here. What sort of eggs do you think they are?
Lizard eggs, because I'm very, very sure spider eggs are smaller than lizard eggs.
Fair enough. You're the expert.
The redback is just hidden away. I dare say it's up under there. And I'll just pull this tub further apart. You never know what's going to come running out of me.
I think that's one of those mole cricket things. I'll just grab it. Okay.
Guess where it's going to go. That'll be something really nice in my deadly spider tank. Yeah. In it goes.
So maybe they are cricket eggs. Possibly.
I just went and grabbed my very special tool that would help me get out the spider, but I just see that she's reappeared, and there's also a there. Okay, she's just coming out from under that tub lid. Got some tweezers here. I might try and grab her with the tweezers. Open up the deadly spider home. This is where I've got to come in really quickly and grab her. Ooh, got her. Okay. Ooh, have I got her or haven't I? Or am I going to get bitten here? Oops, she's lost some legs. It's not looking very pretty, is it? Try and get her again, and I'll get her into the tank, and she will basically become food for the other redbacks at SA because she's injured. Well, she's up on the web there. How many legs has she lost? Can you do a count there? Well, there's a nice close look at her. She's quite pretty, isn't she, in a strangest way? Got some curious red markings there and a bit of white. Unfortunately, she's a couple of legs down. I'll be honest here, I think her chances of survival for very long is going to be very low, because anything that could be deemed as a meal gets eaten up really fast down there. Am I surprised to see a redback there? No, we've had a massive infestation in our backyard. We've been doing a huge cleanup of things, and I will close the spider box up before anything escapes. Even though I think I've got rid of all the redbacks here, I do come through with my tool, and my wife or Mummy thinks this tool's amazing. Isn't that right, dear? Thank you, dear. How often I get a compliment. And I go through like that, and if there is anything in there, it'll be picked up, but it looks clean. And it looks like I've disturbed what was a big ant's nest there. Sorry, guys. We've got to try and get rid of the redbacks. So that's where I moved the tubs from, and if I go out like that, that was the, what I call the major infestation area there, still brewing as I'm making this video. And what we've successfully done is basically made a brand new infestation area right there. Bluebell is apparently in my garage here.
He's in the corner.
In the corner. This is the next day. We are going to take a look at the spider tank.
See?
Where? Dad. Oh! Hi, Bluebell. Fancy meeting you in my garage.
Dad, how's the spider tank?
Let's take a look, hey?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of curiosity in looking at that yesterday, and we might, of course, carry the video on. It is over this way. Well, here's the spider tank on my other bench in the workshop here. I wonder if the things I put in there are still alive or dead. And this is up past week 12, where I start to look for the tank in a far more infrequent manner. And we'll just see what is going on down inside here. What can you see going on?
I think the cricket's dead.
Ooh, the cricket, hey? Let's take a closer look. Rightio, well, down there, obviously a redback spider. I think that was a mole cricket that I picked up. It was a bit darker coloured than the other ones that I've found. That would be a grand mill. It's huge. And what I've noticed is the redbacks love to catch these things. Mind you, I did have that episode where one of those, the argument is, did it kill a redback spider or was a redback spider injured? Also notice here, dun dun dun, an egg sac has been laid up overnight.
Yeah, it's another stark reminder of how hard and fast these spiders can breed. I think that has been one of the shock revelations for me. And also their ability to escape the tank, especially as spiderlings. Mind you, if they are sort of in sleeping mode like they are now, they tend not to be as much trouble. Now the spider I introduced yesterday is down here. My theory on this is I believe that spider is dead. I'll just try and pick it up here. Very hard to look down through a camera and use these tweezers. I don't see it scurrying away and I don't see it balling up. I would say that spider is dead and I'm not sure if I can actually get it up here. Okay, I think I've just got it and I'll lay it here. And I think my theory behind this is that with these spiders and with nature in general, if there's something injured or something that isn't 100%, it's basically very easy to be taken out and it just basically becomes part of the food chain. I've been watching those spiderlings over the weeks get bigger and bigger and bigger. But if you're a redback spiderling, in a funny way, the numbers are always going to be against you. The fatality rate of those guys is just massive, and I have seen a great example of that in this tank. It's really survival of the fittest, or should I say the most deadliest. They'll put some veggies down there during week 12. I'll tell you what, they have been chewed out big time. I'll have to put some fresh food in there. Oh yeah, if you look carefully, then there's some very yucky sort of bugs doing very buggy sort of things. The spider tank is very much a curious thing. You know, I do things in there and even I've got to go back and check out what's happened, who's died and who has survived. I better get some veggies for these guys, some food. That's mainly for the other critters in there, and I'll put the lid on.
Yes, that's a mole cricket. My audience teach me the bugs. Way back when I was capturing these things, I didn't know their name. I called it devil bugs, but the redbacks love them. And there's lots of those in my backyard, as I've worked out. This really wasn't week 13, it was just a time when we captured redback spiders in the backyard on the weekend and we threw them in the spider tank. Logical place to put them, isn't it? Most normal people around the world would be catching butterflies in their backyard, but here in Australia we're catching deadly redback spiders. And where these videos go from here on is the praying mantis versus redback spider, and it's like two prize fighters in a death match. It's the old classic, two shall enter and one shall leave. For me, it's a complex video to bring to YouTube because I would like to have all of the extended pieces in there because I think it's very important to see the times when the two critters are in there trying to work out what to do. Even though in those times there's not many punches thrown, I think they're very important moments because it's the strategy between the two critters which I think is the most important part of the battle. It was really a battle decided by who made the mistake in the tank. Once you make a mistake against a major predator, you really don't have a second chance, and that is the way nature works. One of my biggest fears about this redback spider versus praying mantis video is potentially it's going to be a long video, and yes, there is a cliffhanger aspect to this, and I'd like to incorporate that in the video. It's a complex video to put together because many things happen in this. Some of them are very subtle, and the audience engagement will be fairly poor because people just want to skip to the point where the damage gets done. I know the way people watch these videos. The negative effect on my channel, which has been happening now for about 2 years, I'm very used to it now, is continuing to happen. As you've seen, I've sort of morphed and changed the way from doing things that I used to do. I'm starting to steer clear of toys, I can tell you that. But the most bizarre aspect is looking at spiders didn't help. So don't be surprised if you start seeing me play with tubs of Play-Doh and saying, oh, boys and girls, this is red, this is yellow, this is blue, and this is brown. And you know what the colour of brown is? Well, we can't go there on YouTube because this is Kitty's YouTube. Maybe that gave you a giggle. Anyway, we'll do an old sign-off like the old classic Leo Kim video, and I'll let my son do it, hey? Here he comes. Did you learn anything about capturing that redback spider?
Yes.
What did you learn?
Don't touch them or pat them or anything.
Yeah, especially don't pat them. What do we say at the end of our videos?
Thanks for watching. Bye for now. Yeah.